I'm going to show you how to apply an expression to a comp that allows you to control the speed of your animation in and out, as well as the animation's overall duration. This is a very cool and powerful expression, and you can use it on any kind of animation. This tutorial is more about what this code will do for you and less about how to write it. So we'll only briefly gloss over how to write it and what the code means. I'm also including the code in the description below, and I'll be showing you how to apply it as an animation preset. So you can bring it in with just a click of a button and never have to wonder how to write it again. There is definitely a lot to get through with this tutorial. So let's dive right in. Okay, so we're looking to control three basic things. The animation in, so this distance right here. The animation out, this distance between 2 and 3 seconds. And then the overall duration of the animation itself. So say, for example, if you wanted this animation to only be half a second and you wanted it to stay on screen for 5 seconds, we can do that. This code is a time remap code. So if you right click, we can see that we cannot enable time remapping. This will need to go onto a pre-comp. I'm going to hop over to my edit comp here and I'm just going to drag that in. This is the comp right here that we just were in. We need to add some markers. If we go back into our original composition, and we're going to add in and out markers, but we're going to add it to the timeline itself, not the layer. If you have the layer selected and you edit in a marker using the asterisk key on the number pad, you'll see it adds a marker directly onto the layer. So I'm going to undo that. I get a lot of comments from people who are using MacBooks or laptops and they don't have a number pad. So I'll try to keep that in mind and let you know what shortcuts you can use or another way of doing this. So for those reasons, and also because you want the marker to be on the timeline, not the layer, the easiest way to do that is to grab this marker right here at the end of your timeline and just drag one over. It goes onto the timeline as opposed to the layer. Double click that, name this IN in all caps. Click OK. Go down to the 2 second mark, and again, we're going to drag a marker over, double click, type out in all caps, and click OK. Go back out to our edit comp. We can see that the markers did not show up, but if you right click and go to this markers option and choose update markers from source, they'll pop right in. This is the area that we want to control right here, this out animation, and then also the overall animation. So right now we can't drag over to the right, and moving these markers around doesn't do anything for our animation. Command Option T will automatically time remap your layer. And now I have this code already written and I'm going to paste it onto our time remap. I'm going to kind of briefly go over what this code does, but this isn't necessarily a tutorial about how to write code, but more about what code does. And also I'm going to show you how to save this as an animation preset, and it's also in the description below. So we'll kind of gloss over what it's doing, but the more important thing is how to apply it and when to use it. So option click on time remap, and I'm just going to paste, and here is our expression right here. We're creating 4 variables. We're going to create a variable for where each of the keyframes are. We type a variable and we're going to name it start. If you want the expression to refer to the endpoint, just this layer with a capital L dot endpoint. Put a semicolon at the end of your command. Second one is variable marker N. That's our end marker. And then we're assigning which marker it is, and it's marker 1. And the way to denote that is marker.key and then a 1 in parentheses. The next variable is just like the end marker, so I make it out 2. And that last variable is the opposite of our start variable. We're going to name it end, thisLayer.outPoint. If you're ever typing this manually, just make sure that you're paying attention to when to capitalize which letters, because that does matter. This next part down here is going to execute that code. As long as we have one key, we're going to assign an index to that key, and we're going to look for a comment in or out. Now, the major part of this expression that makes this work is this linear expression. So the linear expression has 5 parts. The first part of that will usually be time. And then we're going to look at the start, which is our first variable, and marker in, which is our second variable. Now, these numbers are the seconds where these occur. Start is going to be at 0, and the marker in is at 1. Whenever you're referring to seconds, think of it as a percentage. So, for example, if you had 1 second and 10 frames, this would not be 1.1, it would be 1.33, because 10 frames is 1/3 of a second if you're doing like a 30 frames per second comp. If this animation went for 1 second and 15 frames, it would be 1.5 because 15 is half of a second. So just keep that in mind. Whenever you write these expressions that refer to seconds, you're going to write them in terms of them being a percentage. That's what this if tag in line is doing. And then our last line is otherwise, if the tag says out, we're going to run this other expression. This linear expression is looking at the animation out. We're looking at time and we're looking at the time between marker out and end, which is our out point. Our animation out begins at 2 seconds and it ends at 3. So the main thing that you'll need to change if you ever use this expression as an animation preset is just pay attention to these numbers and make sure that they match where the keyframes are in your pre-comp. If we just kind of scrub through here, we can see this animation ends at 1 second. Now watch, I can pull this marker over and it's going to end a lot sooner. So now it's only half a second long. Say we want it to go for about a second and a half. Watch it play back and you can see it takes longer for it to come in. And the same thing applies for the out animation. This is where it begins. However, if we want it to hold a little bit longer and be a fast animation, all we have to do is move that marker down and it adjusts accordingly. You can drag this out now and move the marker down with it. It gives you complete control over the speed of this in and out animation and also the duration of the animation itself. And now you can pull either the in or out points. EE to bring up our expression, make sure you have time remap selected. Go up to Animation, Save Animation Preset, Documents, Adobe, the version you're using, User Presets, and I have a folder here for 7-Minute AE, Marker, Controls, Time. Select Save. This expression applies to any kind of animation that has an animation in and an animation out. Let's put a marker for our in and out points. Drag this marker over here, in. Pull this marker out for our out animation. Double-click out. We're at 20 frames, and then also we end at 3 seconds and 20 frames. So I'm going to show you how to write that in the code. Go back out to our edit comp, drag in the shape animation, go to our effects and presets and type in marker controls, and we can see that our preset is right here. So make sure your playhead is at the beginning of your animation, because whenever you apply an animation to a layer that has keyframes, it's going to put the first keyframe wherever your playhead is. And remember, we're going to have keyframes because this is a time remap layer. Time remap layers always have keyframes at the beginning and the end. So with my playhead at the beginning of the layer, I'm just going to double click marker controls time. Press EE to reveal our expression. Now we have our first keyframe ending right here at 20 frames. So it's going to be this if tag equals end line. We're going to change one to 0.67 because 20 frames is 2/3 of 1. And then we also are animating out at 2 seconds, so that one's fine, but it ends at 320. Make this 3.67 because 20 frames is 2/3 of 1 second. Scrub through here a little bit, we can see that this marker is in fact controlling our animation. Go to the end, we can pull this over, we can see that it starts later. You spread this out a little bit. So you can see you can control the speed of this, the duration of it. Here at the out animation, you can control how fast that animates in and out. And that's the expression you can use to control the speed and duration of any pre-comped animation, whether it's text, shapes, video, anything at all. If you'll be applying this as an animation preset, just be mindful of the values in those last two lines of code, because you want those to match the time of your markers as well as the time of your out animation. Otherwise, you could run into some problems or get an error. This is a very powerful expression. Let me know in the comments below if this is something that you find useful. I'd like to thank the good folks over at AE Juice for sponsoring this video. If you haven't checked them out at aejuice.com, I highly recommend you do just that right now. Get tons of free plugins from AE Juice that will save time while adding polish and professionalism to your projects. Get the AE Juice Starter Pack, which contains over 100 assets for your projects, including liquid and shape elements, liquid transitions, slides for your slideshows, text presets, flat icons, 2D and 3D assets, and so much more. AE Juice also offers professionally produced sound effects absolutely free. Other free plugins include a HUD package that is super cool. These elements would literally take hours to create, but with AE Juice, you get them absolutely free and they can be dropped into your project with the click of a button. Some of my personal favorite free plugins include Copy Ease, which allows you to copy the speed graph of your keyframes and paste them so you get identical keyframe speeds. I also use Shifter on a regular basis. Instead of going through the multiple steps of offsetting layers, this plugin allows you to do it with the click of a button, which saves a tremendous amount of time. In addition to these impressive free plugins, you can also purchase advanced products at more than reasonable prices. Take advantage of AE Juice's bundles. My personal recommendation is that you get the I Want It All bundle, which includes everything I just showed you. I've been approached by several sponsors and I will not promote their products unless I support them, use them, and highly recommend them. AE Juice is an amazing product and company, and in my opinion, it's a necessity for any serious motion graphic designer. AEJuice.com.
I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts.
Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rock star. The link to that course, to our 7-minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.